I'll show you how to give your lines an origin to destination gradient effect. Here's the roster for the 24-25 University of Michigan football team. And I've generated lines connecting their hometowns to the big house in Ann Arbor. You know, it'd be really cool if these lines had a gradient that faded in as they traversed this distance. But if I make this line a gradient stroke, the gradient only applies across its width and not along its distance. And that's not what I want. So I'll undo this and think deviously about how to apply a gradient along a line. The secret is to trick the line into thinking it's a really skinny polygon. And then we can give it a gradient fill in any direction we want. So in the symbology panel's structure tab, I'm going to add a global effect called buffer. And then I can fill in these buffered lines. And now that I have a fill layer, I can get rid of that original stroke layer. And now we can give our symbol a gradient, this time to the fill and not the line. The sort of gradient that we give it will be linear and continuous. And I'll set the size to be 100%, so it spans the full distance of the feature. And lastly, I'll zero out this angle. And now I get to play around with colors. Let's give this a more thematically appropriate blue. And I'll open this color's properties and make it mostly transparent. Using transparency for a line's gradient can give a strong sense of direction. The transparent end of the line looks like the origin, and the opaque end looks like the destination. It's that pew 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 school of cartographic directionality. Speaking of directionality though, it looks like the lines on the left are inbound and the lines on the right are outbound. What gives? It's weird, but it kind of makes sense if you think about our hack. These buffered fills don't know which direction they're facing. They're just coloring in from left to right. So I'll just separate these into two different layers. I'll activate my selection tool and grab all of the lines that appear incoming. And I'll pop this selection out into its own pseudo layer, which I can name whatever I want to help me keep them straight. And then I'll do the same thing for all the outbound appearing lines. And now that I have two separate layers, I can just toggle the direction of the gradient for either one of them. And now all my lines have a cohesive direction to their gradient. And you may be asking yourself, John, why didn't you just create a new attribute, calculate the bearing, and then do a symbol property connection to that bearing to define perfect linear gradient angles for every shape? And the answer is, I tried it, and the results didn't turn out the way I wanted. And now a little bit of tradecraft here. If you take a look at your buffer distance, this is the distance drawn in every direction from your line. So the thickness of the feature will be effectively double whatever you put here. For example, if you want your map features to have a 1 point thickness, give the buffer a half a point thickness. And lastly, an alternative to the global buffer effect is the tapered polygon effect. Give that a try. And that's how you can trick line symbology into giving you a gradient along a path instead of across, using the global effect of buffer or tapered polygon. How you can use transparency to give the impression of inbound or outbound movement, and how you can select and then separate the layers to give a cohesive sense of direction.